So last year I meet this cute guy and we exchange numbers and said, why don't we go to the beach? I'll grab us a couple sandwiches. We meet up on the beach and just immediately jump into this awesome conversation about like life and Oprah, which is all flirting to me, but I realized it might not be for him. So I start testing it out. This was not a date. And so I realized, all right, this might not be love, but he got himself some free therapy, all for the cost of two sandwiches. And I also got an idea for a show.
Hi, Chris.
Hi. How are you today?
I'm so good, thank you.
Good.
So thank you for bringing sandwiches. What'd you bring us today?
Of course. I bought Italian sandwiches.
Uh-huh. It's toasted even.
Yeah.
Yumma.
Oh, cheers.
Cheers. Thank you.
Yeah.
Mmm.
No.
Well, all right, listen, this is your time right now anyway, yeah. So let's just jump in. Like, what do you want to talk about?
You know, I've known you for a little bit, and I know that, for example, like, I think you have a good relationship with your mother.
I do.
So, because for me, my background was, I grew up incredibly religious. And so...
Can I ask what religion?
Yeah, they're evangelical Christian.
Okay.
Like, pretty Christian. And so that was something that I struggled with in terms of my own journey into coming out. You know, when I came out to my parents, it was really difficult.
Yeah.
I think the first thing that my parents kind of were talking about were, you know, you're going to hell, the risk of AIDS, and then conversion therapy. Now, that was a long time ago, but we are still no closer in terms of my parents, I think, being okay with it.
Yeah. How do you navigate being you, exactly who you are, and have a relationship with people who are incredibly important to you but don't accept all of who you are?
Right.
So, I mean, what's just been your kind of own organic strategy so far?
When I first came out, I wrote a lot. I mean, I came out, that was its own thing.
Yeah.
Its own thing. and when that didn't go very well,
What does that mean? Sorry, because you just paused there. So it was its own thing.
When I came out, it was explosive. It was not...
To your parents, you mean?
To my parents, yeah. I had convinced myself that this was okay, that they must know that I haven't had a girlfriend and I'm 21, 22. And, you know, they must have some inkling. And that they must maybe think it's okay. And you kind of, like, you convince yourself that. And then when you come out and it's not the answer you want, I left. I had packed, like, my yearbooks, like, stuff that I was, like, in case it wouldn't go well, I brought all that. You know, but I don't want to disdain them, I think.
Sure.
You know, they're from another time, another culture, and I do think that they have tried to make strides to understand, but are certainly not where your mom is, for example, that I perceive, or where a lot of people's modern day, you know, parents are. And it's hard to hear someone that you love and is your parents tell, like, really not, almost like at that time, not even try to understand it.
What would you say is your, like, your ideal goal?
In an ideal world, it would be if my parents were, like, at my wedding.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I think that would be amazing. Maybe they would be. Oh my God.
Oh my God, of course, right? Like, that's the ideal scenario, is that your parents, that your family, that the people that mean the most to you are gonna be so loving and supportive of you, and no matter what, no matter who you're walking down an aisle with, that they're gonna be just so floored the fact that you found love.
Right.
And like a love that's like meaningful for you.
Right.
And there to celebrate that, because it's not just about celebrating that, you know, union or connection, it's about like celebrating exactly who you are.
Right.
Just like wanting that, and you know, the reality of things for you right now doesn't point in that specific direction. And so it's so hard to feel that conflict of where you want to be and where you are.
Right. Yeah.
What do you think, if you were to get to that most ideal place of your parents being at your wedding, loving you, like, what does that give you at the end of the day?
I feel like just like full acceptance.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Totally. Oh my God, yeah. And especially from our parents. That's how we learn that, right? Can we still achieve full acceptance even if we can't get it from our parents?
Right.
And that's when we get to kind of turn inward. And when we do that, then that gives us a chance to be able to honor the difficulties that we've had with our parents and the impact that it's had on us without necessarily kind of like blaming or vilifying.
Yeah, I think those are really good points. Because I definitely don't vilify them. I love them.
Yeah.
I love them to death. And I think that's why I care so much about their acceptance. And I grew up especially in a very strict conservative household, very, you know, grades, church, and a lot of that has gotten to be where I am now. But you do put your parents on a pedestal in that kind of role. Like, they're guiding you. And so it takes a long time to come to the end. That's why it's so important to me.
We actually get model what we want to see, you know? Yeah. So it's like, I'm not gonna beg of acceptance from you. I'm gonna show you what it looks like within me. Otherwise, if the intention is I'm gonna do this to get something from you, approval, love, acceptance, mm-hmm. then that's not love, that's a barter. Love is a gift.
Right.
Yep. How does that sound?
No, I like that. I like that love is not a barter, it's a gift.
Yeah. It is, yeah. Totally. Yeah.
And I think a lot of times people think of it as barter.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Totally.
Yeah.
How are you feeling?
Feel good.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Thank you for sharing all that. That's that to me is a gift. I appreciate your just utter raw vulnerability about everything.
Yeah. Yeah, it's a tough topic, and you know, I think I've grown a lot in terms of coming to accept whatever the relationship. I've come to accept if they're never fully okay with it, I'm okay with that, and that doesn't make me love them any more or less. I just would love the ideal that we
talk
about.
Oh my God, of course.
So.
And I happen to think that, kind of at the core of that too, of just being able to find your own inner peace and your own like self-acceptance and love, I think that part is 1,000% achievable.
Right.
And I think there's so many ways you're gonna feel love. And I also just, you know, just as a human being, I hope that your parents get there for you.
Yeah.
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 Give me a hug.
Yes.
It's Saturday night, and the city never sleeps. It's Saturday night, so baby, why should we? I got a clean t-shirt and a shot of cologne. Way too young to be sitting at home on a Saturday night. It's Saturday night.